Several decades after William Herschel's initial experiments with fingerprinting, British colonial India once again became the site for another important innovation in this technique, one that would even more directly lay the groundwork for the modern identification practices that are used today. In the 1890s, two police officials located in different parts of the globe, independently and simultaneously, developed technical innovations that made it possible to create large collections of fingerprint cards. One of these new systems was developed by Juan Vucetich in Argentina, and the other was developed in India by Edward Henry, pictured above, and his Indian assistants, Azizul Haque and Hem Chandra Bose. The invention of new techniques for filing fingerprint cards might not sound that exciting, but in fact it led to revolutionary changes that would transform police identification practices all across the world. At the heart of both Vucetich and Henry's systems were particular ways of describing the fingerprint patterns found on a person's 10 fingers. Both systems laid down complex rules for describing the totality of a person's fingerprints in a concise formula composed of numbers and letters. Much like a book in a library has a certain call number and is shelved at the location corresponding to this number, the card containing a person's fingerprint record would be filed in the specific location associated with this formula. If the police subsequently encountered a suspect of unknown identity, they could search their fingerprint files for the formula that was associated with that person's fingerprints. If there was already a card at that location in the file, it meant that they had already encountered someone with this general profile of fingerprints. The police could then check to see if the specific information included on the card matched that of the suspect. By following these steps, police officials could identify who this person was and also gain information about any past crimes that they might have committed. While the procedures for describing and classifying fingerprints used in these systems were very complex, we can look at a short example to see what they involved. The first step involved classifying every one of a person's 10 fingerprints according to a small number of pattern types. In the system devised by Henry, every fingerprint could be described as falling under one of these categories, pictured here, based on its shape and appearance. The first step in the process would be seeing which of these pattern types, arches, loops, whorls, and so on, best described every fingerprint on a person's 10 fingers. So imagine a person who has the configuration of fingerprints shown in this table. As you can see here, starting with the right hand, the thumb has a whorl pattern, the index finger has a radial loop, the middle finger has a whorl, and so on. In Henry's system, each type of fingerprint pattern was given a specific value, and this value also varied depending on which finger it was. For example, a whorl pattern on the thumb of the right hand would have a different numerical value than a whorl pattern on the index finger of the left hand. By adding up the values for the fingerprints shown here, according to Henry's rules, one comes up with the fraction of 9 over 28. This is known as the primary classification, and it is an important early step in classifying fingerprints in this system. The card with this information would then be filed away at a location in the filing cabinet associated with the 9 over 28 classification. Additional steps, not described here, would be taken to subclassify this card even further within this category. The invention of fingerprint filing systems by Henry and Vucetich represented a major innovation in police identification practices. Because the files were organized according to a person's fingerprints and not their name, It meant that police officials did not have to rely on the name given to them by a suspect. Rather, they could just check the suspect's fingerprints against the file. These practices went far beyond William Herschel's use of fingerprints as a signature that could confirm identity. Now, one's fingerprints could direct the police to a file containing one's personal information, including any past crimes. While today's fingerprint databases, which are stored digitally on computers, are very different from these kinds of paper-based files, they very much grew out of these older practices of classifying and storing fingerprint records. Thus, we can say that these innovations, which were carried out in the last years of the 19th century, represent a major breakthrough in the development of modern identification practices.